You eat that rice. I don't care if it's white, I don't care if it's brown, I don't care if it's purple. We accept all rice here. Hi honeys, it's Emmy. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Emmy and I'm the creator of the Slim on Starch program. And today I'm gonna be sharing with you guys the top 5 mistakes that I see when somebody's trying to become a healthy vegan. So let's just separate something right here. If you are trying to lose weight on a vegan diet, awesome blossom. I have a video for you. I have a free training that you can get in the down bar. This is more so for people that are not trying to lose weight, but just want to develop a healthy lifestyle and have it be plant-based. So if that's what you're looking for, watch this video. If you're looking to find out how to specifically lose weight, then make sure you get that video in the down bar. So let's get into it. What are the mistakes? Foremost is focusing on the word vegan as opposed to whole foods plant-based. This is the number one mistake that I see because there is an erroneous idea that vegan is synonymous with healthy, but things that are packaged up as vegan, vegan meats, vegan cheeses, yes, they're wonderful for the environment and for the animals, but they're not health food products. They have tons of oil and sugar and salt and preservatives added to them. They're delicious junk food. But did you know that Oreos are vegan? Did you know that Nutter Butters are vegan? It's true. And of course, these aren't things that we want to be downing if we want to be living a healthy lifestyle. So this is why I don't even use the word vegan when I'm talking about my diet, because it is vegan. I am a vegan. I will never eat an animal product again in my life, and I don't use any makeup that's tested on animals or anything along those lines. However, saying that you're eating a vegan diet puts forward the idea that you are just eating a diet that is with the absence of animal products as opposed to eating a whole foods plant-based diet. So let's not focus on what you're not having, which is the animal products. Let's focus on what you are having, which is starches, vegetables, fruits, and legumes. You want to do your shopping in the produce aisle. You want to fill up on things that you know what they are. You know what fruits and vegetables are. You shouldn't eat something if your grandma doesn't know what it is. That doesn't mean you can eat spam. But things like the vegan cheeses and the vegan meatballs and all of that, again, great for the environment, great for the planet, but they are packed with preservatives and things that are not great for our health, and they're very fattening, and they're not going to promote health. Another thing is like when, you know, we're choosing somewhere to go out to dinner, I don't say that I'm vegan because going to a vegan restaurant, it's basically just getting vegan junk food. It's oily and it's fattening and deep fried and all that, and you can get the cheeseburgers and the ice cream, and it doesn't promote a healthy lifestyle, honestly. It's just food with the absence of animal products. I prefer to go out for sushi, to go for Indian food, to go to any Asian restaurant. Steakhouses, believe it or not, are fabulous for a whole foods plant-based diet because you can get a baked potato and steamed broccoli in a salad. So who would have thunk it, right? Mistake number 2 is letting oil sneak in. Oil is 4,000 calories per pound, and it is purely fat. People get all caught up about oil being a health food. It is not a health food. It's not even a food. It's a food product. And even if we're in a caloric deficit, oil is stored on our body as fat. There was a study in which individuals only ate 800 calories a day and they were consuming oil. And when scientists went in and surveyed what was in their fat cells, they found that the oil that they were eating was getting stored directly as fat, even though they were only eating 800 calories a day. So having a little bit of oil here and there, we don't realize how much it adds up. Using just a little bit of oil to saute your veggies, you're just using just a tablespoon, that's like 200 calories and 14 grams of fat, which is not good for the fat that's on our body or our cholesterol either. Our little heart can't handle all of that, and our blood vessels can't handle all of that oil. It just sludges up your blood. It makes you very resistant to insulin, and we want to be sensitive to insulin. So letting the oil sneak in is no good. Oil is not a health food. It is pure fat. And it is, you know, if you're worried about eating fats, eat an avocado, even though you shouldn't be worried about that, which is something I'm going to talk about later. But don't let that oil sneak in because it's going to stick to your hips. Mistake number 3 is doing a cleanse. If you can't do something for the rest of your life, you should not do that thing. So we are building a lifestyle. We're building a plant-based lifestyle. And whenever somebody goes on a vegan cleanse, they do like a 21-day fix or 28-day detox. I'm gonna be perfectly vegan, totally clean, juice detox for 28 days. That is just promoting the idea that there is an end line and basically that there's a big binge fest coming. If you are doing something super, super cleansing, restrictive, first off, it seems like a chore, like something bad that you have to do. And then on top of that, it puts forward the belief that this is a temporary diet and that, oh, I'm just gonna go back to what I was doing before, but let me just cleanse everything right now and then I'll go back to what I was doing before. It's so, so silly. We want to create a long-term lifestyle. In fact, in my program, we actually ban the use of the word challenge because I don't want people to have the idea that this is an 8-week challenge where they have to be perfect, because that just puts forward the idea that this is a short-term diet, it's not sustainable, and that you'll just go back to your old ways before. And honestly, people will end up losing weight and then they'll gain back more weight than they started at when they go on the big binge fest. We don't want this to happen. We want you to create a sustainable lifestyle. And as far as detoxing goes, and cleansing goes, we have liver and kidneys for a reason. We detox every single day. And just by developing a whole foods plant-based diet, your body will detox itself every single day. And there will be no need to go on these extreme cleanses that set you up for failure. Also, just being on a cleanse puts forward the idea that the normal you is dirty and that you have to do some sort of a chore, some sort of deep clean for everything that you've accumulated through all this time, but that's not the case. Mistake number 4 is focusing on macronutrients. Protein and fat seem to be the big ones that people are like, gotta get my fat in, gotta get my protein in, I'm on a vegan diet, gotta watch the protein that I'm having. And once again, this moves us away from focusing on whole, real food, and it moves us into a diet mentality where we're focusing on macronutrients. In terms of getting enough fat and getting enough protein, the fact of the matter is that if you are eating enough calories, you'll get enough fat, you'll get enough protein. We don't need to seek out certain foods that have these macronutrients because all foods have all 3 macronutrients, which are carbs, protein, and fat. So as long as you're getting enough calories on your diet, you're getting adequate amounts of all of the macronutrients that you need. We don't have to worry about which foods have which macronutrients. And when people do this, they make it so that food, once again, is a chore, and they complicate it so, so much that they're likely to fall off the wagon because it's just too much work to make sure I'm getting my fats, to make sure I'm getting my protein, when you don't have to do any of that. You're actually making it harder for yourself, and you're making yourself less healthy because your relationship with food is focusing on the macronutrients of food as opposed to focusing on food as a whole, which is going to nourish you. Just eat a whole foods plant-based diet and eat it in abundance. Also, what ends up happening is people end up getting way too much fat and protein, and they overdo it on the oils and the avocados, and they end up getting way too much fat, not great for the cholesterol, and then getting too much protein is very taxing on our liver and kidneys as well. There's no need for protein powders or protein bars, and in fact, adding those into your diet could be detrimental. And then mistake number 5 is majoring in minor things. I get so many questions about the nitty gritty details and people aren't looking big picture. Is microwaving okay? Should I do organic or conventional? Brown rice or white rice? We can't major in minor things. We can't get lost in the sauce. We have to look big picture. People aren't fat, sick, and overweight because they've been microwaving their broccoli. It's because of the Burger King. It's because of the cheeseburgers. It's because of the animal products and the oil and the deep fried this and that. We have to look big picture. So long as you're eating starches, vegetables, fruits, and legumes, a whole foods plant-based diet that doesn't have any oil in it, you're good to go. It doesn't matter if it's organic or if you're boiling, air frying, baking, microwaving, if your rice is brown or white, so long as it's rice, eat it, honey. You eat that rice. I don't care if it's white, I don't care if it's brown, I don't care if it's purple. We accept all rice. Here. Keep it simple, stupid. That is something I say. I call in my program, we have KISS meals, which is keep it simple, stupid. They are simple meals made up of starches, vegetables, fruits, and legumes. Bada bing, bada bang, you're good to go. Just keep it simple. Don't overcomplicate it. And eat in abundance on a whole foods plant-based diet. Leave a comment of any videos that you guys want to see, and I'll see you in my next one.